The first of this year's Nobel Prizes was awarded today. Jeffrey Brown looks at the advances in treating cancer and other diseases made possible by the work of this year's winners.
In the words of the Nobel Committee, the three laureates have revolutionized our understanding of the immune system by discovering key principles for its activation. American Bruce Beutler and French scientist Jules Hoffmann won for their discovery of the mechanism that triggers innate immune responses. Canadian Ralph Steinman, who taught for many years at Rockefeller University in New York, shared the prize for discovering the trigger for so-called adaptive immune responses. Shortly after the prize was announced, news also came that Dr. Steinman had died this past Friday. And while the prize is generally not awarded posthumously, the Nobel Foundation announced that in this case, its decision would stand. Joining us now to explain the research of this year's winners is Dr. Anthony Fauci, head of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases. Welcome back, Dr. Fauci. So before we get into the details, in general terms, this is about how the body fights disease?
Indeed. What the laureates established and discovered was the precise mechanisms whereby the two components of the immune system are activated, the very primitive innate immune system, which was what Beutler and Hoffmann discovered, and then the connection between that innate immune system and what we call the adaptive immune system, which is a much more sophisticated part of our immune system, which is what Ralph Steinman was able to delineate by discovering this very specialized cell. So it really is a very worthy discoveries of the Nobel Prize.
So start with a little bit more on the innate immunity. This is described as the first line of defense. Now, what does that mean?
Well, it's a very primitive line of defense. It's what very, very early primitive animals have who have not yet evolved into developing what we call an adaptive immune system. It instantaneously senses invaders like bacteria or viruses or parasites. It's rather nonspecific, but it's very instantaneous in its ability to recognize these invaders and to trigger a response that would protect the organism in question, be it an amoeba or a much more developed organism. That's what we mean by innate. Very rapid, very quick, but not very specific.
So what did the discovery by Beutler and Hoffmann allow once you know that?
They discovered the very molecules that the cells that are the cells of the innate immune system use to recognize these invaders, these bacteria and these viruses. The word that was used is a toll-like receptor. In fact, it was from early work that Hoffmann did in the fruit fly, in the Drosophila, where he noticed that they had a gene which, when it was an abnormal gene, they did not defend themselves very well against fungi. And then in the mouse, Beutler showed the same sort of thing to show that these were the molecules that were responsible for triggering this very early response.
Now, the so-called, moving to the so-called adaptive immunity, the work by Dr. Steinman, the intriguing idea here that sort of hit me is that the immune system develops a kind of memory to deal with specific attacks. You said this is more complicated. Explain.
Well, what it is that for the early response, it's very nonspecific, but the adaptive immune system is a much more complicated one, and it has memory and what we call specificity. It'll specifically recognize something, and it will remember the next time you get exposed to that, so it gives a much more robust response. What Ralph Steinman discovered was a particular type of cell called the dendritic cell, which actually bridges the gap between the innate and the adaptive immune system by picking up viruses or bacteria or other antigens, even tumor cells, and presenting those cells, those products, to the immune system that specifically recognizes it. So it's kind of a carrier cell that's able to take whatever it is that you want to respond to and present it in a very specific way to the specific or adaptive immune system.
All right, so how do these breakthroughs translate into treatments or therapies or vaccines?
Well, they're going to be very, very important, for example, in determining the molecular mechanisms of how you activate the immune system, which will immediately allow you to control it, either by boosting it with what we call adjuvants or suppressing it when it gets out of line. Particularly the dendritic cells are very interesting in that they're the front line of the future type of vaccines, are using dendritic cells that you actually pulse with the particular protein that you want the body to make an immune response to, and then you infuse it back into the body so that it now very, very specifically induces an immune response. So it has implications for everything from cancer to vaccination to adjuvants and to protecting us against infections.
And you said it's going to be. Is it not no vaccines yet? I mean, where do things stand?
No, there's no product on the shelf, as it were, that is the result of this. But the science is so elegant in this that there's no question that these are going to be breaking through and really providing some very important countermeasures in the future, be they vaccines or therapies against cancer.
And I do want to ask you before we end here, I mentioned that Dr. Steinman had died Friday of pancreatic cancer.
Correct.
And there was word out from Rockefeller University, where he worked, that he, in fact, had been treated by a kind of experimental immunotherapy based on his own work. I think we're still getting information about that. Do you know much about that, or about?
Well, yes. In fact, he did. You know, he had obviously a very serious cancer. Unfortunately, he died just a couple of days ago. But as part of the therapy, he employed this technique of using dendritic cells that you could actually pulse with tumor antigens.
And
well, obviously, it didn't succeed. He had an advanced form of cancer. He'd had it for a few years. He did relatively well for the years that he was sick, a very, very brave man. In fact, we should mention that he was doing elegant science literally to the very end of his life.
All right. Dr. Anthony Fauci on the three Nobel laureates in medicine this year. Thanks so much.
You're welcome.